So now third down, looking at about 5 yards.
Yeah, good job by the Fighters defense there, sticking their nose up in there, bringing the fight to them. Third down. Big stop here early could get the momentum going in Fighters' way. Empty package here. See a lot of man-to-man against empty.
A lot of movement.
Zone.
Double pump fake. Has no options. Going to try and take it. Has to throw it downfield. It's caught at the 25. And what a job by Daniel Smith extending that play. But the ball may be loose. Frisco's saying they have it. Waiting for the official signal.
I didn't hear a whistle.
As there is now an emergency meeting of the Pinstripes.
He got held up in the air there.
Right at the 25. The entire bench is right there where this decision's being made.
Ooh. Forward progress was stopped prior to the ball coming loose.
So it's Austin Wright saying forward progress stopped. The ball was not a fumble. And Tulsa will maintain possession. Back to what I was saying, Daniel Smith extending that drive and finding Joshua Crockett downfield. What a job by escaping the Frisco Fighter defense. Good evening, everybody, for those just now tuning in. Ryan Medine alongside Dan Rodabaugh bringing you this one. Frisco opened the game on offense after the kickoff from Tulsa. They went down the field, a running play from T.J. Edwards, putting him on the board first. Now Tulsa trying to respond. A toss across the top. Daniel Smith has been wonderful through the air so far this evening, just on the couple of tries that he's had. And this time connects again just outside the 15.
Good quick decision there. They run an out route or a sail route with inside motion and then a slant by the wide receiver and try to catch Frisco in a zone there. Just a lot of times if you make a quick decision with an accurate pass, you can get it in there, and it's not a big hit by the DB. So good play by Tulsa there on first down. They got a good little drive going.
Yeah, Tulsa with a tough season, only 2 wins the entire year last year. Again, it was an inaugural year for them, new franchise, trying to work out the bumps and, you know, whatever else you want to call it, but looking to be better this year. They made a ton of additions in the offseason. Yeah. They've really stacked up not only their receivers but their DBs as well, which, Dan, you're an expert in the indoor game. That's where money is made right there. You have to have a strong line, offense, and defense, but it's your special players, your skill players that are really going to get it done in this high-scoring league.
Yeah, for sure, and you got to have a short memory if you're a DB. So you got to get guys in here that understand the nuances of this game. And even though Tulsa lost a bunch of games last year, I want to say 6 or 7 of them were by less than a score. Oh, good decision.
Smith across the top again. That middle is wide open for Tulsa for the taking and connects again, this time inside the 10, which in the indoor game is, in fact, the red zone.
Yeah, Montero DeBose has had a couple good touches early in the game for Tulsa. He's been lined up in the backfield. He's done some motion out of the empty sets and runs a little kind of slip route there, an option route off the linebacker. Finds the void where the Mac was and good completion.
Two men in motion over to that right side for Smith. He slings it into the end zone, going up to try and make the grab.
He had him.
Falls incomplete, was looking for Rosario.
Yeah, good concept by Tulsa there, kind of a double post concept. And you just kind of got to feather that a little more and lead the receiver, threw it a little bit behind him. But I don't know if Frisco was in a combo coverage zone there, or maybe they're just playing man and we lost our leverage. But got lucky Tulsa missed that one. It's hard to score in the red zone there, so make them go deep in their bag of tricks here.
Tulsa now second down.
Under center.
7-point deficit here. 5.5 to go in the opening frame. This one handed off over the right side, wide open with the hole, and it is a touchdown, Tulsa. And what eyes that time.
Yeah, great answer by Tulsa there. Good drive. Unique. You don't see the quarterback under center too often. Maybe more so as you get closer down to the goal line, but good call by the coach. They just go with the flat jet motion there, handoff sweep to the receiver.
Jonathan Nance getting the score there for Tulsa to hopefully try and even this one up with a PAT. Out to kick this one, Austin Newfield. Kicker for the Tulsa Oilers, and he puts this one through. We have ourselves a ball game.
No, sir.
And that one wide right, no chance, not even close. So Frisco will stay up by one here. And what an exciting start to this ball game. Fighters fans loving it. We'll be back here in just a moment. Well, they're calling it the Red River Rumble here in Frisco, Texas, at the Comerica Center, home of the Frisco Fighters here for the season and home opener for a team that made it all the way to the Eastern Conference Finals for the third straight year. However, the third time was not the charm. They are now 0-3 in conference title games and still missing out on that trip to Vegas to go to a national championships. But like last year again for their home opener, welcoming in the Tulsa Oilers now in their second season as the kick fielded by Tears at the 5 has room on that right side. Only made it to about the 15 last time. He adds about 7 yards to that this time and gives TJ Edwards, the quarterback for the Frisco Fighters, a nice starting place on the field. Ryan Medine alongside Dan Rodabaugh in our second season. Third for me, second for Dan. He did so well last year that the league demanded they put him back on the broadcast. Can't say I could argue with that decision. Good to have you back, Dan. And, I mean, you're a guy that has lived and breathed the indoor game since, that's what, 10 years now? Two-time AFL champion, MVP quarterback. You've done it all.
I've been fortunate to spend a good amount of time around this game, and I'm happy to be involved with the Fighters and grateful for the opportunity to come back this year. And, hey, we're already in a back-and-forth match in the first game.
I'm glad to know me holding a jukebox standing outside your window ultimately worked to get you here as that pass is completed to another returning player for Frisco, Cole Blackman, at wide receiver, and flips the field, gets back to the 15 of the Oilers.
Yeah, he's going to see a much more expanded role this year. Coach Coles is raving about his ability and his versatility, and Frisco no huddle here, in and out quickly.
No doubt TJ Edwards was going to keep that one. He ends up falling down. I wouldn't even say it was a dive. Looked like he got tripped up a little bit just inside the 15, only a yard.
He put quite a move on that linebacker there, but he still was able to stick his arm out and trip TJ up just a little bit. But trying to go quickly there and catch him out of sorts. But Tulsa is a defensively sound team. They played pretty good defense last year. They kind of struggled on the offensive side of the ball. So look for them to continue to have tough defense, especially their middle linebacker, Jones. He's a nuisance out there. And you ask anyone else around the league, and he's the first guy they mention on their defense.
He's the player that's the most frustrating to play against, but he's your favorite player if he's on your team, as Edwards, with an empty back, takes the snap. That ball bouncing and out of play for a souvenir for a young, lucky fan. Marvin Jones, head coach, by the way, of the Tulsa Oilers, his second season. That record of 2-13 carrying over from last year again in that first year was a very big struggle for Tulsa, but they've made a lot of adjustments and changes this year in the offseason. They brought back a good portion of that roster, but I just think a second season, you know, that first one's always so tough.
Yeah.
Not for Frisco maybe, but it happens.
No, they've got some great players. You know, Trey Harvey's been a player in this league for a while. He's had an impact everywhere he's been. And that's what good coaches do. You know, they make adjustments. They put the right guys in their staff to help them be successful. And Tulsa's fan base last year was really good. They drew well for their games. And I'm glad they're in the league and on the ascension. So,
you mentioned how strong the DBs are for Tulsa. We're getting a full-on display of that right now. Cole Blackman had no moves to make. Only grabs a couple more, and it's fourth down. So Frisco
yeah,
in
big
a position.
Play
they got to make a big play, score, or turn it over.
I like it. They're in empty, but I don't imagine Trey Harvey's taking a wide receiver man-to-man, so my mind's telling me zone coverage. It's definitely zone.
Low snap. T.J. Late. Edwards making the best of it. That ball high and intercepted in the end zone. Now going back the other way, Taylor Hawkins jumping on top of that one and making an immense amount of progress, and that is exactly what you don't want to happen in the first game of the season for the Frisco Fighters.
Yeah, bad decision there by the quarterback. You have to understand, get you a pre-snap read there. Trey Harvey out there over a wide receiver immediately tells me it's zone coverage. If you're trying to hit the corner there in the back of the end zone, you have to read the front side corner.
7-6, Frisco Fighters leading, but a massive interception could change that. Find out next. Back here in Frisco, Texas, after the interception from the Tulsa Oilers off the shot from T.J. Edwards into the end zone. Ryan Medellin, Dan Radabaugh here for the home opener, season opener to get this IFL season started for both Tulsa and Frisco. However, were a couple of games last weekend. Can't lie to say I was a little scared when I saw games happening. I was like, wait a second, we're not playing tonight, right? No, we weren't. We had one more week to get ready for this one. And certainly needed to, just trying to digest the season that was for the Frisco Fighters, whether it was on the field or off the field. Lots happening, coaching changes, player things. I mean, it was everything. And Andre Coles, who took over as interim head coach, he had the work cut out for him, was able to lead the team to that Eastern Conference final with a, gosh, I don't know if it gets more heartbreaking than the loss that we saw on this field just around 6 months ago.
It's offsides on the motion. Oh.
That ball down on the ground, and jumping on top of it is a Frisco Fighter, but there's multiple flags down. It was on top of it, Caleb Thomas.
Illegal snap, offense, number 68, 5-yard penalty.
Yeah, I think the high motion man was about 4 or 5 yards downfield before he even snapped that ball anyway. So not a lot going good on that play, but to be expected in the first week of the season. Yeah, that was interesting. He fake snapped it. Our rookie nose guard down there was ready, though.
Just under 30 seconds to go here in the opening frame here in Frisco, Texas, here at Comerica Center, home of the Frisco Fighters, as that ball tossed to the right side from Smith. And not a lot of running room. Still going to be shy of that original line of scrimmage, or maybe right back at it.
Tulsa's using some unique formations already. They've had the back mugged up tight into the line of scrimmage, and there you see a lot of kind of loop, almost like an old school veer and toss offense. So
now it's third down and 11 as we reach the end of the first quarter. Frisco Fighters leading by 1 point here in Frisco.
but to lace up. Every day is game day. Off my third contract, you still on that same play. Lying harder, but I got the eye of an eagle. I put the city on my back. Look, I'm gonna ride for my people. And once I take the stage, I'ma start like Evel Knievel. I built to conquer heights. My mind's a Danny DeVito. And once I get my first ring, I'm manifesting the sequel. Yo, this the IFL. Swear to man, become heroes of in the end. Are you ready for that?
Ryan Medine, Dan Radabaugh here in Frisco, Texas at the Comerica Center. Looking at the 2023 season for both the Tulsa Oilers and the Frisco Fighters, I mean, vastly different years they had. Frisco 14-3, 2-13 for the new team in the Tulsa Oilers. But you look at that last matchup they had back in May of last year. It was a two-point win for Frisco, 39-37.
A heroic last-second kick by Bryce, I believe it was.
It was, and the britches were a little tight there as a flag gets tossed up in the air. Smith scrambling, makes the connection.
Man, he's done that a couple times, getting out of trouble, making a nice throw. But Frisco, the dogs came out of the pen right there. Solomon Wise and Charles were both in hot pursuit.
Montero DuBose with a catch. We'll see what Austin Wright has to say about this one. Austin Wright, we know him very well.
Offside, it's number 9. 5-yard penalty, replay, third down.
It's probably, he called the DB offsides?
Yeah, the offside going against Devon McCoy.
He probably means Solomon Wise there, 8 at the end. It looks like he was just a little early on trying to time up the snap.
Yeah, I guess the jersey might have been scrunched up a little bit. That can happen sometimes.
Yeah, on the replay, it showed it a little better than we may have had our vantage point.
We're all working out the first game kinks.
No doubt. Even the players are.
And broadcasters.
Yep.
Definitely the broadcasters. Awesome. So the Frisco Fighters still on defense after that penalty, giving up some free yards to Tulsa, trying to get ahead. And this one has launched down the field. Smith, that one too far. No chance at all for Nance to make that catch.
Good play by the fan back there, but Frisco in a little bit of zone, kind of in a third and medium situation. Tulsa, good timing by the quarterback. Got it up and down. If he could have just feathered it in there, similar to the one they had in the red zone before earlier. But Frisco not making anything easy for him. Big play here, fourth and medium. Frisco needs to stop to try to get their momentum back.
Nance would have loved to add a second touchdown to his total this evening. He had the first one on a rush on the previous offensive drive for Tulsa. Remember, this drive started off an interception thrown by T.J. Edwards. Smith trying to make the most of it. This is a deep pass. Caught!
Oh, great catch.
And he's going to be spotted down at the one-yard line as it's Joshua Crockett, who is the leading receiver so far. Before that, two catches, 21 yards. Add another 20 to his total.
Joshua Crockett actually has some Frisco Fighters experience as well. In 2021, he was never active, but he was on the team for a few weeks in practice, and he really showed out. He actually signed with the XFL after that, and he's found a home there in Tulsa, and they sure do like to try to wear him out. He gets the ball a bunch.
502 receiving yards on 47 receptions, averaging 10.5 a catch. Also 18 receiving touchdowns, 7 more than anyone else on the roster last season.
Ooh.
As this ball is handed off, and what a stop right at the 1-yard line.
Good hit. Micah Smith has his nose in there. Royce C., a veteran middle linebacker for us. Frisco's always been tough to run on there. Good job by the defense. Iffy handoff. That was almost bobbled in the backfield. That would have been great if Frisco could have got their hand. Look, you see there? Bad mesh.
Happened almost so quickly that you thought it was potentially still Daniel Smith with the ball.
Yeah.
The way he snuck that in there. But What a stuff by this Fighter defense, fighting for the lead right now, up by one. Smith going to go under center. Takes the snap, tosses it. Morsel-Ache chunks it back and into the end zone. Tulsa finally breaks through as it's Montero DeBose grabbing another one for Tulsa.
Yeah, great call by Tulsa there. Go under center again. Utilize the flat motion to try to get flow in the defense to go with the motion. You just pitch it back to the back. They've got a lineman out front. He kicks out the linebacker. Frisco's outnumbered there. Great job by Tulsa. And they're going to waste a timeout here.
They're going to take it.
Timeout. Kicker wasn't ready.
So you score the touchdown. You have the momentum, and now you burn a timeout, which are extremely valuable here in indoor football. Well, Oilers on top, 12-7, first time with a lead this evening. We'll be back in just a moment.
To the DBs.
Out of the timeout, Ryan Medine, Dan Rodabaugh, the Tulsa Oilers striking that liquid gold with a Montero DeBose run into the end zone to take the lead over Frisco. Now appears that they will go for two. So was the timeout a little extra time to strategize? You know, they had the missed PAT on their first score, trying to get things back even to 14 and maintain a 7-point lead.
Yeah, let's see what they do here. They're in a pistol formation.
Smith with no time making the toss, and the ball is caught, but unfortunately by a fan and not a Tulsa Oiler, so the two-point attempt is no good.
Yeah, great pressure there off the edge quickly by Solomon Wise. He's a rookie, but, man, he's out here putting his imprint on the game already. Big fella. Frisco's happy to have him. Need to get some offense cooking here, though.
The Tulsa Oilers having their way with this Fighter defense despite their best efforts. Six plays, 27 yards, 4 minutes and 34 seconds off the clock, ending in that touchdown, all started by that interception by T.J. Edwards. It took a while, but the snake finally came back to bite after that mistake on the offense for the Fighters. It will be very interesting to see how they respond.
Yeah, Frisco needs to put together a nice drive here. Don't press, though. Just relax. Let the game come to you. It's only your third possession here, but we need to go down and capitalize and get six.
Spencer Tears with a light jog, getting into place ahead of picking up another kickoff. He's run a couple back in his career. Again, a lovely crowd here on hand in Frisco, Texas tonight for this one.
Yep.
This home opener here on a Friday night. In this wonderful venue that is the Comerica Center. Also home of the Texas Legends, the NBA G League team for the Dallas Mavericks. This one doesn't make it back to Tears as Lionel McConnell, the product of a NFL family. Cousin plays for the Jets, Bengals, Giants. Graduated from Allen High School, though, so was definitely there in their heyday.
There you go, man.
Probably got to play with Kyler Murray a little bit, maybe even.
He was pretty good, right?
I've heard things. Something like never lost a game in his high school career.
Yeah, not too shabby.
I would probably say that accounts for a rating of good.
Real good. Come on, TJ.
T.J. Edwards, again, returning for another season for the Frisco Fighters after earning 2023 IFL MVP honors last season after putting up ridiculous numbers as he hands this off to Smith. And that front three for Tulsa leaving no room for error.
Yeah, pre-snap there. They've got five players in the defensive box. They're Trey Harvey is lined up in the box. He's their jack linebacker or underneath safety, whatever you want to call him. But they've had the right scheme called defensively for every play Frisco's got going so far tonight. Frisco's got to figure out what they want to do. You got to get some pre-snap reads. Here he is lined up over a wide receiver. This is telling me zone coverage right away, pre-snap.
A little bit of debris on the field if the Edwards decides to go for a long pass on the right side. No, he'll go to that left. And Devon McCoy with the catch. But, again, it's, you know, they're completing passes. They're doing the right things. But, goodness gracious, there's just no room after the pass is complete. These guys can't move.
Yeah, Tulsa, when they play zone, they don't blitz their linebackers. So they've got five guys back in coverage and only three rushing. And they're doing a good job holding their lanes against TJ, too. They're not just flying upfield and giving him lanes to take off running, too. So Frisco hasn't utilized a ton of empty formations just yet either. That's how you get good matchups.
Edwards 5-7 with that lone interception that cost a touchdown for the Fighters. It wasn't a pick six, but it happened pretty shortly after as he runs it up the middle. There is a flag in the backfield, though, thrown by Austin Wright, our head official. And it sounds like this one's going to come back on a holding. Let's hear from Austin Wright.
Holding. Offense. Number 70. 10-yard penalty. Replay. Third down.
So it'll be a replay of third down, and they will be pushed well behind the chains. 5 yards to be exact. But, you know, it's when you're always trying to compare any kind of football to the NFL just because that's the standard we all know so well, and a 5-yard penalty, you're like, oh, that's not that big. Well, in the NFL, it's huge.
Yeah,
and it's a 10-yard penalty if you're thinking about it from NFL standards. Everything's kind of half. That's the best way to remember it.
Yeah, and, you know, it came in a critical situation there too. Third down, TJ converts with his legs. Now we've got a big chunk we need to get back here. It's not an all or nothing, though. You can pick up some here and go for it on fourth down, and this is telling me pre-snap this looks like zone.
Is a big play, though. Frisco needs to try and convert, but not even an opportunity as it's a false start.
Motion man offsides.
Called before Edwards could even make a play. Here's Austin Wright.
False start. Offense, number 10, was more than a yard beyond. 5-yard penalty, still third down.
So it's Cole Blackman, the receiver, on the false start.
Yeah. They get him for a false start there. They just call him offsides on the motion, which is not on the wide receivers. It's on the quarterback to snap it in time. So definitely, like you said earlier, maybe some first game, not jitters, but kinks we got to work out.
Well, you go back to the interception. It was a low snap that Edwards didn't have the amount of time he probably would have liked to take a look at the coverage downfield and heaved one up.
That's why a pre-snap read is so important. And they're telling you what the coverage is pre-snap. He's just got to figure it out.
Edwards scrambles, still has the ball. Now lobber to no one as that ball falls at the 10, but not a fighter within reach. And, boy, talk about a deflated balloon of offense for the Frisco Fighters. And now facing fourth down, we'll see what Andre Coles decides to do. But
he's got Bryce out there. He's probably going to do a directional kick out of bounds deep in the end zone or inside the 10-yard line, but TJ had Cole Blackman wide open in the middle of the field in zone coverage, and he's just got to be able to find him there. He's pressing a little much, trying to do too much. Hey, when you're the reigning MVP, I'm sure there's lots of pressure on him. He may be putting on himself, so just relax. Let the game come to you. There's a ton of football left to be played, but
keep in mind, too, we talked about a lot of names missing from the Frisco Fighter roster this year. A lot of those are receivers. I mean, Jerminic Smith, Jayzion McClurge.
And linemen, too.
And linemen. A lot of crucial pieces the Fighters have not brought back.
Still fourth down.
So a penalty is called on Frisco, pushing them even further into their own zone. So now Crawford kicking from about 5 yards. And all signs appear to him going for it. Like I said, we've seen him hit a couple of deuces before. As this ball is up.
Oh, got to cover, hustle.
And that ball is going to get to the 5 and returned by Tulsa. With all the space and time in the world into the end zone, there is a flag.
Trey Harvey on the return, but it's got to be a hold.
Like you said, Harvey on the return, Bennett Harvey. We'll have to see what the flag is. It's right shy of that 25. the risk of kicking a field goal.
Yeah.
Here's Austin Wright.
During the return, unnecessary roughness. Return team, number 90. 15-yard penalty. It's first and 10.
We'll take it.
Unnecessary roughness, a gift from the football gods for the Frisco Fighters, because that will rip that touchdown return from Harvey off the board, and a 15-yard penalty. So what was a 45-yard return now puts the Tulsa Oilers just outside of their own 10 at the 13.
Yeah, big break there for Frisco, but they've got to find some continuity here on defense. They got to get some stops, figure out what Tulsa's doing, trying to put their finger on the pulse, but Tulsa is steering this game how they want right now.
Both of the drives the Oilers have scored on have lasted well over 4 minutes, which is a lifetime.
Yeah, that's a long drive in the football.
Smith with the handoff. And he is wrestled down.
Yeah, they're trying to utilize that jet motion there, and Solomon Wise flying upfield, gets his hands on the back.
Montero Dubose on the carry.
Yeah, quarterback may have been able to, Dana Smith may have been able to pull that one and get north and south, but Frisco closes the door quickly.
Dubose and Nance with the touchdowns for the Oilers. Dubose 5 carries, 11 yards gained.
It almost looks like Tulsa's letting Daniel Smith either dictate the protection or what he wants to do at the line of scrimmage.
You know, it's the first game of the year when you see as many flags as we've seen so far here.
There was another late one.
And there are 3 down on the field at the moment.
Yeah, I think they're all going to be on the Frisco Fighters.
Lots of strain being worked out here this evening here in Frisco, Texas, here at Comerica Center. Ryan Medellin, Dan Rodabaugh, 2-time AFL champion and MVP quarterback, the Red Rocket.
Offside defense with contact, number 99, the 5-yard penalty. Personal foul, unnecessary roughness. Defense, number 11, the 15-yard penalty. Ooh. Automatic first down.
It's a buy one, get one special, Dan.
Yeah, Charles handing out freebies there. Gave the quarterback a little shove a little late, but
20 yards worth of penalties on that one play.
About and half the field.
Things continue not to go well for the Frisco Fighters, down 12-7 here in this home opener. Got to be a frustrating start, not only for the players, but for head coach Andre Coles as well, as Smith trying to see if he can hit the pay dirt. This one lobbed, end zone, caught! What a catch on the fingertips as Joshua Crockett reels that one in and puts the Oilers well ahead of the Frisco Fighters.
Yeah, good job running through the ball there. Comes up with a wonderful catch. That's a great throw by the quarterback, too. Wonderful anticipation. It feathered that one just perfectly over the defense. That's a good call by their coach there. Crockett shoots that gap, kind of a slant, and go right up the middle. And great execution. They, you said it earlier, they're doing what they want.
A team that went 2-13 this last season in their first year, now giving the almost Eastern Conference champions a run for their money. Now up 18-7 off probably one of the opening week plays of the week for the Indoor Football League. And this time the point after is good. Make it 19-7. The Tulsa Oilers having their way with the Frisco Fighters here at Comerica Center.
but to lace up. Every day is game day, off my third contract, you still on that same play. Lying harder, but I got the eye of an eagle. I put the city on my back, look, I'm gonna ride for my people. And once I take the stage, I'ma start like Evel Knievel. I built to conquer heights, my mind's a Danny DeVito. And once I get my first ring, I'm manifesting the sequel. Yo, this the IFL, swear to man, become heroes of in the end. Are you ready for that?
Fans not in the building for this one, taking it in at home. Not the start you'd like to see for our Oiler fans on the road. You're absolutely elated right now as that kickoff rolls into the end zone and is grabbed by a fan before it went out of bounds. He's got a souvenir, but Spencer Tears a bit frustrated that he didn't have an opportunity to pick that up. So the rule is, as you heard Austin Wright as I talked over him, that the ball will be placed on the 5-yard line, but still frustration from Spencer Tears because he knows he probably could have put the offense in a good spot, and that's desperately what they need right now.
Yeah, they got to get some life going, but Tulsa's kind of hit three or four interesting kickoffs. They're kind of using that knuckleball that just give it a good drive, hope to get a big bounce over somebody's head, and
exactly what happened.
Yes, sir.
Well, a happy fan, a mad Spencer Tears, TJ Edwards now.
Man-to-man.
Trying to find some sort of continuity for the offense to get back on the board after the opening drive touchdown as he is pushed into the wall by Harvey.
Harvey's all over the field, isn't he? He's returning kicks. He's tackling the quarterback.
Looking at my roster, I'm like, are there multiple Harveys or what's the situation? No, well, it's just Bennett Harvey, the linebacker, 6'1", 235.
Former Frisco Fighter.
Former Frisco Fighter that knows the turf well, if you will.
Yeah. Here you go. They're showing their hand every single play, Tulsa is. We have to get better at pre-snap reading if we're TJ here. Zone coverage.
Short dump pass over to that left side.
You got to read your numbers right there too, right? You got two DBs on each side and a free safety high, and the Mac linebacker is shifting to the boundary. Throw the ball to the field. The throw to the wall is wide open. It's a first down. TJ's got to make better decisions.
4:45 mark here in the second quarter. 19-17 lead for the Tulsa Oilers.
Man-to-man.
Ryan Medellin, Dan Rodabaugh bringing you this one.
There you go.
That ball handed off over on that right side and sweeping across is Jimmy Smith. Making it to the 20, but ultimately gets the move, the chains on third down, something the Fighters struggled with on a couple of previous drives.
Yeah, maybe that's the one to get us going here. Good job by Jimmy. Good call by Andre. Good hard run.
Game of momentum. That last drive for the Tulsa Oilers, just two plays, 37 yards and a touchdown. All that drive started by that missed field goal attempt from Bryce Crawford that was returned for some hefty yardage before the penalties brought it back. Another dump pass from Edwards, this time over that left side.
Yeah, got to put it on him there. Give him a chance to do something with it. We need our MVP to get us going, get us in a rhythm.
Blackman having to stop and fall down to catch that ball. Didn't have a lot on it, but still makes the completion. Second
zone.
Down, about 4 yards to the first down as Smith rolls. Gets the cross the 20, gets the first down, which is most important. And like you mentioned, maybe this is the drive that Frisco needs. It's a game of momentum, and right now it's all Oilers, but Frisco, we've seen, can bounce back from a little bit of adversity. It's not something unfamiliar.
Yeah, we got to keep it going. I'd like to see a little more life out of Frisco, but, hey, 2 or 3 yards, little chunks at a time, they add up.
So Edwards with Smith next to him. Option, toss to Smith. Nice spin.
Whoa.
And jumps across the 15. He's been extremely, extremely active this evening, Jimmy Smith, who again is returning to the Frisco Fighters this season. So far, he has 6 carries for 20 yards.
Yeah, he's a good player, and Frisco's going to have another good back join the team later in the season, Martez Carter, when he gets done teaching. But Jimmy Smith is a wonderful back to have out here. Scored a whole bunch of touchdowns for us last year, and it looks like he's picking up right where he left off. Empty set, I like it.
Fighters within striking distance. Keep an eye out on Cole Blackman, number 10, to that left side of TJ Edwards. This is where he can thrive. Edwards with a long look, now has to scramble. There is a flag down, and based on the location of Noah Johnson, it might be a holding against him.
Yeah, it might be a second one.
And penalties continuing to plague these Frisco Fighters.
Illegal defense, number 44, lined out inside the yardage results in a first down.
Well, apologies to Noah Johnson.
Yeah.
I saw him standing up right next to the flag looking a little flabbergasted. Well, he was flabbergasted because somebody wasn't where they were supposed to be on defense.
Yeah, those cheaters over there. But good job by the refs making sure to see that.
It's our 10th penalty so far this evening, and we're only still in the first half. Under 2 minutes. No 2 minute warning.
1 minute.
It's a 1 minute warning. Again, if you're confused about the indoor game rules, just half everything
the
NFL has.
And double the scoring.
And double the scoring. Touchdowns are worth the same. PATs worth the same. Going for two is still going for two. As the sweep across, no, it's a fake. Edwards ducking down. And, you know, one of the things that we talked about with Andre Coles is, you know, knowing that TJ Edwards is a returning MVP, he's going to have a target on his back. And a main thing for him will be to be very smart this year about protecting himself. And I think we're seeing a little bit of that where, you know, maybe old TJ Edwards would try and burst through that. But
yeah.
He decides to be smart, go down, and knows that it's a long season. This is only game one.
Well, you said it earlier. He had 900, just about 900 rushing yards last year. So he's going to take his share of collisions and blows out there. But he's always done a good job kind of avoiding that big hit. But let's see how we handle this 1 minute warning.
7 of 10 going into the 1 minute warning for TJ Edwards. 70% for 48 yards. His long is 12 through the air. He's got 4 carries for 24 yards, averaging about 6 a carry. And we're going to take a short break. 19-7, Oilers leading. Ryan Medine, Dan Rodabaugh here in Frisco, Texas at Comerica Center. A big play coming for the Frisco Fighters out of the 1 minute warning as they look to strike again. It's been since their first opening drive of the game, receiving that opening kickoff where they scored off a TJ Edwards run. They're trying to get back to the end zone as the hit or the handoff to Smith gets inside the 5. And as a reminder, as we're now under a minute, Tulsa won the toss deferred, so they will get the ball to start the second half. So
yeah, if I'm Tulsa here, I'm calling timeouts. So I get the ball back with a chance to score and get it to start the second half. I'm not sure exactly what they're doing. I think they may see some struggles that Frisco is having and saying, hey, if you can score, score. But Tulsa's, they've had an answer for everything that Frisco wants to do on offense. Tulsa is come ready to play tonight at the Comerica Center.
Very, very strong outing for this first game of the season for both Tulsa and Frisco. More so for Tulsa as Edwards again having trouble with the snap, escapes the first tackle. The ball is whistled dead before he could heave it out. And
he was definitely in the clutches of a defender, but TJ the Magic Man.
Trip Harrington made that catch. Austin Wright saying forward progress had stopped. I would love to take another look at that one.
Yeah, it was just like you said, though, it all starts with TJ not catching the snap cleanly. It looked to be a good snap. He just didn't catch it.
Here's another look at it, Dan. And the call was that forward progress had stopped. But, again, this third snap he's had trouble with.
Ooh, that may have been a little early on the whistle, but Austin and them said that they're protecting the quarterbacks. The quarterbacks are what drives this league. So
yeah, and look, huge shout out to Austin Wright. We've worked with him a ton. We usually get a chance to chat with him before the game.
They do a great job.
He and his crew do a wonderful job, and they are as transparent as can be. And I guarantee we'll have a note in our inbox tomorrow letting us know the ruling and the actual rule that is attributed to that call, as Bryce Crawford trying to kick a field goal, and that one gets shaded to the right side. It looked exactly like Austin Newfield's attempt earlier from that exact same spot.
Yeah, Fighters are out of sorts right now. That was a not good operation all the way through there. Bad kick by Bryce. So defense got to stand strong to come out to start the half. Well, I mean, you got to finish here. 4 seconds left. Anything could happen. You know how indoor football goes, but they got to turn it on here in the second half.
4 seconds left. Joshua Crockett, who's been returning kicks for them, he ran one back. He had the help of a holding call, but he has shown that he can be a threat. However, that ball is going to get placed at the 5 because of the missed field goal. But I imagine Crockett will find his way somewhere as the target, intended target. He's a huge quarterback favorite target again.
Yeah, that's great catch he had earlier. Don't count out a bomb down the field here to try to give him a chance.
4 catches, 59 yards and a touchdown, 22 yards his long. However, Smith has been solid, 6 of 8 for 65 yards.
Oh, I don't like zone here. I don't like zone here.
This is a big pass and batted away. And the Frisco Fighters minimized the damage here in the first half. 19-7, Oilers lead. We have a great program coming for you coming up here at half. Enjoy.
Another episode of Pass the Sticks. I'm here with my dog, Jimmy Smith. What's up, bro?
What's going on, baby? What's going on?
Listen, bro. So listen, we're going to talk some trash, you know what I'm saying? Play Madden, also get to know you a little bit more. But before we start, I just want you to know I have never lost yet.
Okay,
I just beat one of your teammates, bro.
Cool.
So you think you're going to beat me?
We'll see, man. I don't really know how you play. We finna find out.
I don't know. Before the game, you was changing your uniform, changing your playbook, you know, all that. Like, usually when people do that, they actually know how to play Madden. So I'm kind of
nervous, it's bro. Just, you know, the Jaguars had a tough ending to the year, and I know Madden gonna mess with the adjustments, so I'm not beating people like I used to.
Listen, why? Are you from Jacksonville?
I grew up. I was born in Dallas, and I moved to Jacksonville. My dad played for the Jags.
Oh, word?
Yeah.
Okay, so your dad played in the National Football League.
Yeah, man, yeah.
That's fire. Okay, yeah. That's what's up, bro. Growing up with a dad that was in the league, like, how was that kind of as a kid, bro?
It was lit, bro. Like, just being around the players and your mentors, and, you know, you get to hang out with them all day. Fred Taylor, like, I was hanging out with his son, you know.
Fred Taylor, fire, bro. I ain't gonna lie, that's lit, bro. Listen, bro, my dad walked out of my life, bro. So, shoot, I ain't getting none of I ain't getting none of that experience, but... This is what I'm going to do. Today, I'm going to be your dad, bro, in Madden. I'm going to be your new dad,
bro. Oh, my God. No, you didn't.
I'm going to be your new
dad. Okay, bro.
I'm going to be your new dad in
Madden,
bro.
Listen, I got to put on for the city,
listen,
man.
Listen, you're old. Listen,
nah,
you're,
no.
Listen, no. Your dad was in the professional football league. I'm a professional Madden league, bro.
Okay, bro.
I'm in the NFL.
We finna see, man.
Look at my plays, bro. Hold on. Aren't you looking at my plays?
I'm trying to set my defense. You got the two-time champ.
I think you're actually kind of good, because the last person I played in the last episode, bro, he was not that good, but now I got to actually try.
I'm decent.
You know what I'm saying? But, hey, bro, so when did you get into playing football? Was it like growing up seeing your dad? Is that what kind of motivated you?
Oh, yeah, for sure. My grandpa played in the league.
Oh, word?
Yeah, man.
Oh, so it was a family
league.
Oh,
yeah, for sure.
Ah, come on, Patrick, bro. Hold on, bro. Why is your defense so good? Hold on. What you know that I don't know,
man,
bro?
It's 4-1, man.
You got me nervous right now. Hold on. I got to lock in, bro. Are you Jimmy? Are you Junior?
I'm the third. My grandpa's Jimmy Smith. My dad's the junior. I'm the third, man.
Wow. So if your name is Jimmy Smith, you pretty much like bound for great football. That's what it is.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, for sure. That's why I love the Frisco Fighters. You know, they're keeping my career alive and helping me stay in shape. And, you know, if I ever do get that call to, you know, get the chance to go play for my hometown team, that's still the dream. So,
respect, 100%.
Oh, my gosh. You got me, bro.
Hold on, you know I'm a Swiftie.
You got these questions, man. You a pretty good interviewer, bro.
Yeah, I appreciate that, man. That's love, man. So, listen, bro, I'm a Swiftie. So, basically, with that being said, bro, every time I score is only going to be with Travis Kelce.
Oh, here you go with this.
I'm joking, bro. See, you were focusing on Travis because I said that, but then I do this.
Oh, my goodness. Man, I'm in the wrong defense, though. That's for sure.
Oh, Lord, B. here you go with the excuses, bro. You know you about to get that body in your face, bro.
That's not an excuse.
Yes,
I was in the wrong defense.
Nah, bro.
That's kudos to you.
Okay, but we gonna see, bro. You know, I met you, bro, like a couple years ago.
Yeah.
My second ever tryout in 2022, I met you. You had like, I think you had a Cardinals shorts on.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah.
I went to University of Louisville. I transferred from Louisville to Wyoming. So, yeah, I got a chance to play with so many great players. Lamar Jackson, Jair Alexander.
Yeah.
And
so you literally, like, was hanging out with Lamar and all the new?
Yeah, bro. Giving the rides, the workouts and everything.
Nah, that's so
it's so crazy seeing him. Now, I remember, like, the first day of workouts, like, he wasn't big on working out.
Lamar?
And, yeah.
What?
Like, not at first. He was, like, just fast and athletic.
Okay.
But, like, as like, his process began, like, he had the heart and just, he went to work. And, like, he's big, like. You can see how much work he's put in.
Yeah, no, he's pretty big, bro.
Come on, there we go.
Ah!
There we go.
All right, bro, listen, man, listen. I was trying to keep it cool, have an interview with you, bro.
Here we go.
I ain't gonna lie, now we finna get into Madden, bro. We finna...
Let me turn up on this, man. Come on. We gonna see, bro. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, it's 9-0, folks. Okay, you gotta show me, bro.
So your dad played for the Jags?
Yeah.
That's crazy,
he
bro.
He got drafted by the Cowboys in 92.
Okay. And you're from Dallas?
Yeah.
Damn. So he is too?
He goes from Dallas to Mississippi. He's originally from Detroit.
Okay.
And he grew up in Mississippi. Went to Jackson State University, college. So
you were born in Dallas because your dad played.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. He's been my mom in Dallas. My mom's family's from Dallas. So.
Okay, that's fire. So my boy was on like a bye week or something like that. Met your mom's, man. You know what I'm saying?
Hey.
He made a legend. That's what's up, bro. That's fire, bro. Heck yeah, man. Come on, bro. How's that not a fumble, bro?
Let's go, Chilo. He's trying to talk to me and get me off my game, but I can't let that happen.
You know, it's called pass the sticks for a reason,
bro. Uh-huh.
Once you lose, you're going to have to pass the sticks, bro, to the next player, bro. You're going to have to pass the sticks to the next player, bro. You know what I'm saying? If you lose, bro.
Okay.
And I'm not getting pie to my face. You know what I'm saying? I'm 1-0 right now in this series, bro. I can't go out like this, bro. Did you watch the Super Bowl? You watched the big game?
Yeah, bro. It was a good game. I don't know why everybody hating on it. That was a good football game. If you love football, that was a great football game. It may not have been interesting in the first half to y'all, but that was a great chess match. And I really hate that the San Francisco defensive coordinator got fired, because I don't think...
He got fired after that?
Yeah, man, he got fired.
Wow. So tell me this, bro, because I've heard this a lot. So, like, is the football industry, like, gritty like that? Like,
oh, yeah, it's cutthroat.
Yeah, so you mess around, miss a kick as a kicker, you done. Like,
I'm not going to say that in everybody's case, but in some cases it do be like that.
That's crazy, bro. Yeah, because you grew up around it, bro. Your dad being, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he definitely. If you go read about him and Jerry Jones and read into that situation back in between 92 and 95.
So your dad kind of had a little bit of smoke with Jerry Jones at the time.
Yeah, a little bit. Plenty of stories with my dad. He's told me plenty because, you know, he was with Michael Irvin.
Okay.
Wow. So many different receivers, man.
That's legendary, bro. So what position?
Oh, I don't even know, bro. You got me over here, bro.
What position?
Here you go, man. I'm running on 4th and 6.
Wait. What position you play, bro?
I play running back, bro.
Oh, word?
Yeah, man.
Well, you know what I'm saying? I'm the receiver, bro. What's up? You know what I'm saying? We gonna be...
You good?
Hey, man. You see me in the tryouts. What you think?
Hey, man. I think you got a lot better, for sure.
Don't lie,
bro. Dude. I mean, I'm not saying, like, you know, you the man. I'm just saying, you know, I saw your 40 and all your times.
It improved.
So
okay.
I think that's something you should definitely build on.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. That's love, bro. You think the next Justin Jefferson or what?
All right, bro. You're taking it too far with that.
Well, people say I look like him.
That don't mean nothing.
For real?
You know, I'm going to keep it G-rated. That don't mean nothing, bro.
Wait. So just because I look like somebody don't mean I can play like him?
No, bro.
You got to put up points in the first half. Oh, come on. Let's go, Patrick. Slide. We got a good game on our hands, bro.
I'm still tripping. I ran it on 4th and 6, man.
Ooh. How old are you, brother?
I'm 28, man.
Nice. That's what's up, man.
How old are you?
25. In a couple days. Yep.
Come on. I'm reading it.
Nah, that's supposed to be a catch, though, bro.
I know you thought
you read it, bro, but you can't read, bro. Just like me in third grade, bro. I couldn't read. That's why I failed, man. You're not even going to acknowledge the fact that I failed third grade, bro. You're not going to give me no
Bro, money. I'm focused on the game. Man.
See, that's how I do it on passing sticks. I get in people's head, you know what I'm saying? Throw that, no cap, you're not getting me. I'm at least coming out with 3 points. I need something, bro. Your defense is actually pretty solid, bro. For somebody who plays running back, how you know how to read my offense, bro?
Dude, I'm just really lining up how you... I'm not really trying to give you anything. I'm trying to stop this little route you're doing, this little quick game. It's the same route. I'm just trying to see what I can do to bait you again. Come on.
Oh, see, I had you, bro, but not another time. Fourth and goal. I'm gonna take my three, bro.
This is a quick game. When we play 3 minutes. Oh, you faking it.
Ah!
Oh, don't make it be a safety. Come on, okay, I'll take it.
Ah, come on, that's supposed to be the 1 yard line, bro.
I had a feeling he was gonna do some slimy stuff. Talking about some fake field goal.
Hey, it's Madden, bro. You gotta have fun in Madden, bro. What's your reason, bro, for football, like, to keep going? Like, what's your
really, my family. Like, I love the feeling of, you know, my mom watching me, whether it's on YouTube, TV, in person. Just having them there and just, you know, putting on for them. I want to keep honoring my people's legacy.
No!
What I tell you, man? It's real quick in here, man. It's getting real hot in here. Hey, don't throw me a pick, so I'm acting fool. Don't throw me a
no.
Boy.
Oh, let's go. I'm a Swiftie. Hey. That boy's a liar.
Don't do that again.
I probably should get out of this cover.
Yeah, get out of something, because you a liability. Oh, come on. I see what you're doing. Come on.
What you see, though? You said you see it, but, like, what's up, though? Like, where's the glasses?
You ran a deep concept and threw it short and got 3 yards. That's good.
That's what I do. Wait, what's a deep concept mean, bro? I should probably learn these things, right?
Yeah, bro.
Playing wide receiver.
Yeah, bro.
I don't even know what a dig route is, bro. I ain't gonna lie. So let's go. Damn! That's not a first? Who?
Oh, you lucky. Come on. Don't do me like that.
Don't do me like what? Where's that energy? Now, boy, don't play with me, bro. This is pass the sticks, where when you lose, you gotta pass the sticks to the next player and get hit with pie in your face, cool. Bro.
One thing about you, you be real confident in the things you say. Like,
my ex kind of said the opposite. That's why she cheated on me with a D1 football player, bro. You've been through that too, right?
No, bro.
Why everybody keep saying that, bro? I thought that was relatable, bro.
Got that shit. You
know what I'm saying? I thought that was normal. See, my editor, like, I be telling him to cut embarrassing stuff and he keeps it in so that my fans laugh at me, bro.
Is he really your friend? Or is that, like, just
ask
for the
media? Can you press him for me, please?
I don't know that he's doing that for real. I mean, you could just be telling me that. I don't want to just... He seemed like a nice guy.
Why would I lie to you? Do I seem like do I look like a liar, bro?
I don't know.
Look at my face, bro.
I mean, why you put me in this position to do this to you? Nah, no, folk. Everywhere we go,
come on,
Friday,
bro.
Saturday, Sunday.
Come on, bro. Nah, the game ain't over yet.
It's 9:04.
I still got 2 minutes, bro.
Duval.
Lord help.
Oh, there you go, throw that. Oh, yeah. Thank you.
I don't want to get pied in the face.
Don't
please
you
back.
Do that,
please
no,
pitch it
no.
Back, bro. Please,
don't
bro.
You do
bro,
that, no.
I don't
bro. Want
to get pied in the face, bro. Are you taking
Bloody
knees?
Eight.
Taking knees in 2020.
Dead.
We gotta head outside for it. We gotta head outside.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, man, yeah, bro.
What you about to do? You about to, shit, I don't even know how to say this in a non-weird way, but shit, you about to get this right here.
You about to put cream on his face.
Oh my God, bro. You didn't even count me down or nothing, bro.
Yo.
You didn't even do a countdown.
Hold on, wipe your
head off your eyes. Oh my. Man, what the hell, bro? All right, man. Hey, make sure you guys stay tuned for the next episode of Pass the Sticks to see who's going to get pied next, if it's going to be Eli or my opponent, bro. Big shout out to the Frisco Fighters. Make sure you guys smash that like and that sub button. Hey, another big shout out to Jimmy Smith for coming out here.
Hey,
good sportsmanlike conduct.
Yes, hey.
My boy.
Nah, good dog. Man.
Respect, bro.
All right.
We out, man. Peace.
Welcome back to Comerica Center here in Frisco, Texas. Ryan Medine, Dan Radabaugh for this season and home opener for the Frisco Fighters and season opener for the Tulsa Oilers in their second season. Frisco going 2-0 against Tulsa last season. Tonight's contest A little bit different of a start than Frisco is used to. They are down 19-7, just about 2.5 away from the start of the second half, and the Tulsa Oilers won the coin toss and deferred, so they will start with the ball to get things going. Frisco Fighters, their only touchdown coming on that opening drive, ended by T.J. Edwards with a run into the end zone. But as Montrose and, excuse me, Nance and Crockett scoring for the Tulsa Oilers, it's been a really interesting first half, Dan, as I bring you in here, because if you look at the stat sheet, first downs, Tulsa 7, Frisco 7. This is where it starts to get a little interesting. Passing yards, 65 for Tulsa, 42 for Frisco. The one thing I've noticed when we look at passing right now, though, and the way this game is shaken out so far, is that it seems like Frisco, on their passes, they're not getting a lot of yards after the catch.
No, and typically in zone, that's what happens, right? The defense trying to keep everything in front of them so they can rally and tackle. And Tulsa, I'm thoroughly impressed with Tulsa coming out ready to play tonight after a tough inaugural season. Then you come in and take on the big dog Frisco Fighters, and they have not been scared. They've come in here and hit the gorilla right in the mouth.
Montero DeBose, also another one with a touchdown for Tulsa Oilers. It's been very interesting to watch Frisco struggle the way they have. Typically, they're a team that, even if they have a difficult second half or any of their losses, if you go back and look at it, it's not because of the way that they have started. And again, take it with a grain of salt, because this team is completely different than what you had last year, the team that made it to the Eastern Conference Final. But the one thing that remains the same, the two things that remain the same, is head coach Andre Coles and T.J. Edwards at quarterback, which are arguably the two most important pieces within a franchise. Definitely going to be some growing pains, especially for not only Coles to figure out what he has in these new players, a lot of them rookies, but T.J. Edwards as well, figuring out who he can trust and rely on.
Yeah, and it's only the first half of the first game, you know, so I expect the team to gel and mesh and come together, and having a great player and leader in T.J., he's going to raise the level of play of the players around him as well, so just look for them to settle in. Had a great first drive, kind of went a little ice cold there to finish the half, but they're going to go in their bag of tricks. They'll get the right play called at the right time. I expect Andre to have a good play in this half and Frisco to answer and get right back in this ballgame.
And here's the deal. This ain't like college football where one loss ruins your chances or anything like that. And this is still a very close game. Not saying that Frisco is going to lose this game, but when we talked to Coach Coles before the game, his really main goal was to us that let's just figure out what we have.
Yeah.
A lot of changes this year. Let's just figure it out. And let's try a bunch of different things and see what works.
Yeah, and he understands with a new group, some new faces, a new scheme, you're going to take some lumps here and there. And he understands it's about making progress each week, getting better each drive, each possession. So I look for Frisco here. Pin them deep. Let your defense pin their ears back and try to get in a rhythm. See if you can't get a stop or a turnover. And then offense, we need a quick score. And we're right back in this ball game. And that's how Frisco plays. They play well off of each other offensively and defensively.
Crockett, the returner for the Oilers so far this evening. He's got one return for 12 yards. That's the only chance he has had as this ball gets picked up at the 15 and dragged to the 20. Still running, but they're going to go ahead and knock him down as it's Harvey on the return.
Yeah, Harvey's having a great night. He's off to a quick start. His dad's over here standing by his
room. Is that his dad?
That's
I heard
his
him
dad.
Say, yeah, I heard him.
Rooting his son on. That's a great thing about the Indoor Football League, man. The interaction with the fans and families, it can't be beat.
Bennett Harvey having a nice evening.
Yeah, he's off to a hot start. He's the starting Jack linebacker. He's on all the special teams. He's the football's found his hands a few times. He even had a touchdown that got called back.
Yeah, he did. Off of a return.
Yep. Look at how Tulsa breaks the huddle there. They sprint to the line of scrimmage. Tulsa's on a mission tonight. Frisco needs to match their intensity.
Not wasting any time. If they want to match that intensity, that's a good start right there.
Good play. Yep. They've gone to the well a few times there with that jet motion. Solomon Wise on a great stop, showing off his athleticism. Coach has been drooling about him. And that's how you stop that jet sweep right there. You can see the Tulsa coach on the sideline, the offensive coordinator, telling the quarterback, hey, you probably should have pulled that one.
Again, lovely crowd on hand here tonight to take in this home opener for the team that almost made it all of the way last year. Three times the Fighters have been bested in that Eastern Conference final, and the defense building off of that last stop with another massive one. The other linebacker, Royce C.
Yeah, Royce C., great job. Glad to have him back. He's a great leader. He's an explosive player at the Mac linebacker position. Gets back there, gets a sack. And his buddy Charles Williams, no stranger to the offensive backfield, goes back there and is disrupting things early.
Talk about coming out of the gates blazing. We'd love to
this is how
Coach
you want to
Coles
start.
Coach Coles said in the locker room, probably just, hey, let's relax a little bit.
Yeah.
The game is still very much up for grabs.
Yeah, woosah, right? Take a deep breath. Third and long, right where you want him. Be smart. No dumb penalties.
Precarious situation for Daniel Smith. He's going to toss it. This time it's a catch made by Crockett. Who else? He's been his favorite target this evening and has always found open space.
Yep.
So Crockett making his fifth catch, now breaking the 60-yard barrier this evening.
Yeah, good decision there by the quarterback. Gets it out of his hands quickly. Crockett on a nice hook route about 12 to 15 yards downfield into zone. That's a great decision. Good read by the quarterback. Out accurate on time. Catch, pick up a big chunk, but they still got fourth down here. Frisco needs to stay strong.
This is where you see those two stops the defense made well behind the chains paying off right now, because now it's still fourth down and five to go, even after the big catch by Crockett. Smith going to go through the air again. This one into the end zone, and this time no dice off the fingertips. Falls incomplete, as that ball was intended for Alexis Rosario.
Oh, he almost had him. That was almost a wonderful hookup there by the quarterback and receiver. But just a little out of reach. Great job by Frisco. Hey, on fourth down, it's either touchdown or we get off the field on defense. So they bring pressure. Charles gets in the backfield quickly. Royce C. was also free. I tell you what, I'm impressed with Smith. He's done a wonderful job with his anticipation and touch on these footballs. He's not missing them by much. So, Frisco, keep the pressure on. Make them make those tough throws, but this is exactly the start we wanted.
Smith with the Barnstormers last season, playing in 12 games. It's 97 for 161. It's about 60% in the air, putting up 1,000 passing yards. He has looked stellar so far this evening, enough to give the Oilers a 12-point lead, but Frisco trying to change that here on their first offensive drive of the half. And this handoff to Smith as he powers through, grabbing an extra couple of yards. And this Frisco Fighter team already looking a lot different than that team we saw in the first half.
See a little more energy and vigor in each step. You see Damian Love turns right back to the sideline, gives him the keep it coming sign. I love it. Being physical there on first down, get Jimmy Smith involved. Here you go, second and short. Get some rhythm.
You grab some points here, that changes the entire direction of this ball game, as Edwards ducking underneath the driving defensive line of the Oilers. Keandre Hall, the linebacker, not able to put a body on him.
Yeah, good job there by Tulsa having a against a speed option. Everyone's got a responsibility, and they hold sound to their gaps and their man, and nothing there. TJ tries to open himself up with a little fake to the back there, but good job by Tulsa. Big play here. Just need a yard. Don't have to get crazy and fancy. Run your best play right here.
Frisco wearing those sweet baby blues. I know they are the broadcast's favorite jerseys that they wear. Led to a lot of success last season as Edwards, again on a quarterback run, keeps
good job.
It.
Good job.
Grabs the first down and decides doesn't need any more than that. And this is what you got to love when you have a fresh set of downs inside that 15. Plenty of time and space to work with.
Yep. Now, as you work closer and closer towards that goal line, though, once you get inside about the 10, especially inside that 5-yard line, it gets tougher and tougher to score, especially through the air. You've got that added defender with the back wall of the end zone kind of as that extra defender, so things get really condensed and not a lot of space to breathe. So,
TJ Edwards facing a bit of adversity this evening. He typically has his way with defenses. That's not been the case here this evening with the Tulsa Oilers. And again, he's trying to change the tune of that story as Smith, this time has nowhere to go, gets double-teamed and pulled down.
Yeah, so anytime Frisco's lining up with a back in the backfield, Tulsa is using their extra linebacker in the back, or in their defensive box. So they've got five guys to stop the run, and we're only having three people to block with the offensive lineman. So we're actually outnumbered by, two guys there, and TJ's not pulling it. So
one of those being Jordan Jones, who, if you followed IFL football, you know what a gauntlet that guy is.
Yeah, he's everywhere on the field defensively, and he's not afraid to remind those offensive players that he's here with maybe a little extra shove or physicality. That's the type of play you want out of your linebacker.
Another chance for Frisco, only second down. Still plenty of room to work with. Nine to go. Another bad snap as Edwards traces
throw
back.
It away.
And he tosses it as he goes into the wall. That ball is high. And no opportunity for Spencer Tears to catch it. That is the fourth erratic errant snap we've seen.
Yeah, TJ went flying over the wall there. Hope he's all right. Yeah, he's tough. He comes right back.
But that snap has been an issue.
Yeah, it wasn't even close. Great job by TJ to get on it. Ooh, it looks like they probably should have ruled him out of bounds. He was touched into the wall there.
So he slowly walks back over to Andre Coles to talk about the play call here. Now third down and 10, so.
Don't need all 10 here. You can call your two best plays and pick up 5 yards at a time, and we've got a first down. Oh, gosh, we're calling a timeout. Okay. Want to make sure we're all on the same page, I guess.
As you heard Austin Wright say, it'll also be a media timeout, which means we got to pay some bills. So we'll be right back. Oilers leading 19-7. However, Frisco, they're charging. We'll see what happens coming up next.
But to lace up, every day is game day. Off my third contract, you still on that same play. Lying harder, but I got the eye of an eagle. I put the city on my back, look, I'm gonna ride for my people. And once I take the stage, I'ma start like Evel Knievel. I built to conquer heights, my mind's a Danny DeVito. And once I get my first ring, I'm manifesting the sequel. Yo, this the IFL, swear to man, become heroes of in the end. Are you ready for that?
Third down and 10 for the Frisco Fighters, needing points. Edwards has time. No! All the time he had got sucked away. And that is a massive, massive stop there by Noah Lyles to pull down the 2023 MVP and put Frisco in a fourth and long situation, desperately needing some points.
Yeah, TJ has to do a better job of discerning man versus zone coverage there. And Tulsa's just playing zone, and they're giving you the short underneath. You just have to take it right away. Don't be greedy. Don't hold the ball. Get it out on time. Make the defense be sound. And right now Frisco's playing right into Tulsa's hands.
Crawford has already missed two field goals. Granted, one of them was from his own end zone. The second one right from about this spot might have been actually a little bit closer this time.
Good kick.
Is a perfect kick. And like you said in the break, Dan, you just need some points. It's okay if it's a field goal. You just need something on the board to just give yourself a little bit of breathing room and to get some sort of momentum back into the offense.
Because you know what's always luring after a touchdown or a field goal? The deuce.
The deuce. And we've seen Bryce Crawford make a couple of those. Again, a rule that they enacted last year. It used to be you could only do it towards the end of the game.
Yeah, inside the last minute, and then last year they let it happen.
Anytime you want.
Yep.
If so, you can make it, go ahead.
Yeah, deuce here, and it's a touchdown ball game. So,
Ryan Medellin, Dan Radabaugh. If you are a fan of indoor football and familiar with the AFL, which how are you not?
Now look at this formation, the return here by Tulsa. They only have four guys on this half of the field. Onside kick. Onside kick, do a high pop-up. You've got seven guys to block. They only have four men up.
Definitely does not seem to be stepping up for a deuce. And this time it's a low line drive. Picked up at the five. And making his way down the field, Joshua Crockett.
Now what's the difference between him returning it past the midfield and you attempting an onside kick and them recovering it?
Crockett has had his way with this special teams, the Frisco Fighters, on these kick returns. I mean, he's been stellar. You look at that first half, He had a couple for a handful of yards. This time he adds to that total.
Yeah, well, let's see if the defense can build off their last stop. They came out with some fire and were able to push Tulsa back and get the ball back for the offense. Develop a little rhythm here. Come together as a unit and make another stop.
Massive fourth down turnover that led to the 3 points. Frisco would have loved seven. And, again, you go back to, like, last year, you're thinking, gosh, Frisco having to settle for three. They needed that right now. Down 9 points. Daniel Smith, again, with the Iowa Barnstormers for 12 games last season. Quick pass. Nice catch. Caught. And dragged down Micah Smith.
Yep. Again, I'm impressed with Smith. He's deciphering what he's getting. He knows what he's getting. He's getting a good pre-snap read. As soon as the ball in his hand, boom, it's ready to come out to which receiver he's decided. Accurate pass. Doesn't have to be a 20 or 30-yard bomb every play. Take what they give you.
And Smith having a really solid evening, 7-11. 81 yards and a touchdown through the air.
Oh.
The missed fake handoff, and that certainly didn't fool Charles Williams. One of the first times we've gotten to really say his name this evening.
Yeah, good job by Charles getting back there. And yeah, that was kind of a misdirected misdirection.
Yeah, you look at the replay here, Dan. And
he's handing it to nobody.
Handing it to nobody, and Charles said, I'll take it.
Yeah, you give Charles an inch out there, he's going to take a mile. There's no doubt about it.
Had help from Desmond Rayford.
Yeah, Rayford getting into action. He looks to be a D end and could probably also play Mac linebacker, but looks to be a high-energy player and a new addition for the Fighters.
I'll tell you what, Charles Williams on that left side, Rayford on the right, that's a scary-looking outside edge. And this Fighter defense is hungry.
Yeah, good job there. Great job by Ethan Castleberry, the defensive back, to shoot up in there and get his nose involved and make a tackle around the line of scrimmage. He's a big fella. For a defensive back, he's about 6'4", 210, 215 pounds. Nice addition.
You know, we talked to Coach Coles before the game, and we mark up our sheets about things he tells us and players to watch. All I have next to Castleberry is a star. He's the only player that I have a star next to. It's like, hey, watch this guy.
Yeah, he said he's going to be the leader of our secondary this year. Is actually really good friends with former Fighter and Defensive Rookie of the Year last year, Cordell Jackson. Both went to Austin Peay, and we're glad to have him here in Texas.
Certainly right now.
We got false start here on the offense.
Timeout.
Oh.
Got a timeout in.
It sure looked like that guard jumped.
Oilers got that in. We'll take the break with them. 19-10. A 9-point lead for the Oilers. 4:33 left here in the third frame. Back here in Frisco, Texas, Ryan Medellin, Dan Radabaugh here as a massive fourth down coming for the Tulsa Oilers and quarterback Daniel Smith. Frisco needing a stop. However, the completion, getting the first down after the catch from Rosario, and things continue to move forward for the Tulsa Oilers, who are, I don't want to say shocking the watching audience and the lead that they had. I think everybody realized when they saw some of the moves that were made heading into their second season that this was going to be a team to be dealt with.
Yeah, Tulsa, fourth down there, they just run an old school arena route, short storm. You got a go route and an out route. the cornerback turns his head with the go route, you throw the out route right away. Good decision by them. Good call. Good execution. Frisco's got to be expecting it.
I think they call that the Rodabaugh special. Smith tossing it. End zone. The doors of the bench of Tulsa open.
Come on, guys. Got to keep those close.
No catch for Jonathan Nance, but a dangerous situation of having those open.
Yeah.
Although, you know, maybe not as dangerous because you have a little leeway to when you fall.
No, it's dangerous because guess what's on the other side of that?
Concrete.
Yeah.
Fortunately, everybody gets up okay.
Yeah.
Including Nance, who...
That was another well-timed, anticipated throw by the quarterback. Just out of reach by the wide receiver, but it's an us or nobody situation.
Smith all alone.
Oh, gosh, he's wide open.
Tosses a bullet into the end zone, and like Rodabaugh said, wide open. Alexis Rosario putting the Oilers back on the board for the first time here in the second half.
Yeah, just a double post concept. You've got kind of the first post runs more of a crossing route, and the second guy goes to the back of the end zone. Frisco looked to be in kind of a combo coverage, and what beats combo? Two routes going in the same direction there, and you know, we've got a bunch of rookies out there in the defensive secondary, and you can tell a little bit. Good call by Tulsa. Great throw. Frisco's just got to try to put the fire out here.
Just when he thought Frisco was mounting some momentum, the Oilers doing a nice job. It's a bounced snap and trying to go over the top, not able to kick a field goal. Is broken up by the Frisco Fighters, but... It was an exciting couple of seconds as it was Joshua Crockett who was the holder. Didn't even have a chance to place it. Let's see if we can get another look at it here.
They didn't even block Rayford. Now, we always had a rule. If you were unblocked on the field goal, you go down through there and you kill the kicker. You hit him as hard as you can. Because it's hard to play football without a kicker, right?
I don't think you can say that anymore, Dan.
Hit the kicker very, very hard.
Oh, boy. I'm just giving you a hard time, partner. Certainly could use a little bit of brevity.
Yes.
With how this game has gone so far this evening for the Frisco Fighters. But, again, first game of the year. These two teams have been looking at tape for the past 6 months. You better believe the Tulsa Oilers had this one starred, not only because it was the first game of the year, because also – you have a little bit of that Texas-Oklahoma rivalry, the Red River Rumble. They're calling it here in this indoor war.
There's a new trophy for it.
There's a new trophy. It's got a boot on it. I mean, who wouldn't want to take that piece of hardware home?
That's right.
Going 0-2 against the Frisco Fighters last year, they certainly wanted to snag this one against a team that everybody had going to the national championship and potentially winning it last year before being upset by Sioux Falls in the Eastern Conference Final.
Another knuckleball.
And getting to just shy of the 20 is Lionel McConnell. About to approach the two-minute mark here in the third quarter. Always talk about how much time there is and how even though it's a 15-point lead, there's still plenty of time. There is. But the Frisco Fighters really need to, we talked about need points last drive. They need to find the pay dirt this drive, Dan.
Yeah, they got to find the end zone anyway, anyhow here. They're cranking the clock, so let's go. And I think Frisco's always played better when they play a little faster. Don't give yourself time to think about what's happening. Just go out there and react. So lean on TJ here to get us going. Harvey lined up over wide receivers. This is zone coverage.
Three of them on that right side as Tears goes into motion with
there
Blackman.
You go.
And that ball is tossed wide to that right side of TJ Edwards. And it's caught.
It's caught by our Swiss Army knife this year, Trip Harrington.
Yep.
He's a backup quarterback. He's a wide receiver. He's a running back. And what did Andre say? He even plays a little defensive back.
Does it all.
But I like the quick decision there. TJ understands that was zone coverage. You're going to get it out of my hands to the soft spot of the field. No, it wasn't a 20-yard gain, but you're chipping away at it.
A couple of times he's taken a little too much time, not that time. Edwards scrambles, has space, and does what he does best, and that's put his head down and get to the 20, maybe a yard shy of that first down marker based on where we're sitting. Looks like he'll still need a little bit of work. for third down.
Yeah, he had a guy there. I think he had the back out of the backfield too. Zone has given TJ some issues tonight. He's not seeing the field particularly well. He's holding the ball a little bit. Needs to come out of his hands a little quicker, but third and one, very manageable, especially with TJ in the backfield. Any play in the playbook is up here.
Still three options over on that right side. Smith joining Edwards in the backfield. And that's exactly who gets the rock. And all they wanted to do was get enough for that first down, and mission accomplished in that regard.
Yeah, whatever it takes. You got to find a way to get in the end zone here. So good job picking that third down. Jimmy Smith's been running hard tonight. First guy's been it's taken more than one guy to bring him down, and he normally brings a contact to that first guy trying to tackle him.
Smith, 10 carries, 36 yards gained, averaging about 3.5. Edwards, toss, end zone,
oh my.
And dropped. Trip Harrington cannot believe he could not put hands on that one. Was wide open in the end zone. And it is no dice for the Frisco Fighters as we head to the fourth and final frame here in Frisco, Texas.
Every day is game day, off my third contract. You still on that same play. Lying harder, but I got the eye of an eagle. I put the city on my back. Look, I'm gonna ride for my people. And once I take the stage, I'ma start like Evel Knievel. I built to conquer heights. My mind's a daily defeated. When once I get my first ring, I'm manifesting the sequel. Yo, this the IFL. Swear to man, become heroes of in the end. Are you ready for that?
Well, back here in Frisco, Texas, Ryan Medine, Dan Rodabaugh, a drop pass from Trip Harrington, the Swiss Army knife of the Frisco Fighters, appearing a little dull on that one as TJ Edwards not able to connect, so it'll bring up second down, and Frisco Fighters now only have 15 minutes to grab at least 15 points. Granted, that's the Tulsa Oilers don't score anymore, but the clip that they're going off on right now, you'd have to expect maybe at least a couple or more with the way that Daniel Smith, Jonathan Joshua Crockett, Alexis Rosario, Jonathan Nance, DeBose, they've all been wonderful this evening so far and have given this Frisco Fighter squad a tough test in front of their hometown crowd. High snap, Edwards pulls it down. Nice job on recovering and dives across the 15, grabbing about 4 yards. And again, the snapping of the ball continues to be an issue this evening. That's the fifth one we've tracked that has not been clean.
Yeah, great job by TJ. And it's hard to read the coverage when you've got to catch the ball in the shotgun or even jump up to try to catch an errant snap. So good job by TJ. But Tulsa's showing their hand pre-snap. We just got to get our fingers on the pulse there and figure it out and get it to the open guy. But starts with the center quarterback exchange every play. It's got to be crisp.
First game of many this season. This snap is low. Plenty of flags down on the field as Edwards gets pulled down by Jordan Jones. The flag's up in the air right as the ball was snapped. Let's see what Austin Wright wants to share.
Legal defense. Number 99, Tulsa, not down in stance and snap. 5-yard penalty, still third down.
So it's Adrian Hernandez, the defensive lineman for the illegal defense. And a breath of fresh air for the Frisco Fighters, now third down and one.
Yeah, definitely. Much more manageable situation. But we got to clean up that snap. Too many low, too many high, too many where TJ has to make a miraculous play just to get the ball in his hand. So,
Richard Ramirez at center.
Man to man.
This snap is perfect. Handed off to Smith, who gets inside the 10. And a first down with a roughly 8 yards to go before the end zone. And that is set up Frisco with all the downs they need to make something happen. And they better do it quick here while there's still only 13 minutes left. It's only 15 points. They got to do something with this drive. And Smith doing exactly that as he tries to power through.
Runs over his own guy there.
Makes it all the way to the 2. And sets up Frisco for an opportunity to punch it in.
Yeah, they try to go NASCAR package there. No huddle. They have a big positive gain. But Frisco has to capitalize here. Nothing less than a touchdown. It's got to be a touchdown. Oh, heavy package coming in the game.
So Ramirez goes out. Damian Love, Henry Mitchell, and Noah Johnson. Mm-hmm. Now that heavy package on the front lines. Trying to give Edwards time here. They do a wonderful job. Edwards to the outside, reaching into the end zone. Touchdown, Fighters! And T.J. Edwards getting this crowd here in Frisco back on their feet.
Yep, great play by T.J. there. Hey, when things are hard, call your best player's number there. Quarterback draw. T.J. very patient, waiting on a hole to open up. Has to kind of create his own lane there out to the outside. Good thing he's really, really fast and sneaks around the corner there and into the end zone.
And thanks to the efforts of Mitchell, Love, and Johnson, he had just enough time to do what he needed to do and find that space. So now Bryce Crawford.
Big kick right here.
Out to kick the PAT, trying to make it 17 for the Fighters. And Austin Wright puts his hands up. It is good. And the Fighters now just 8 points away from squaring this one up at 25 at the 12:01 mark here in the fourth quarter.
Stay in the fight.
Looks like a heated discussion happening on the field between Harvey and Austin Wright. I'm not sure what about.
Harvey definitely thinks he might have been blocked in the back there by a wide receiver. And to be honest, from my vantage point, he might have a foot to stand on in that argument. But no call, 6 more for the Fighters.
This is where you got to watch out with Joshua Crockett, who has been a return machine so far this evening when granted the opportunity.
Only 4 guys on that side of the field again. Onside kick.
He's back there with Jonathan Nance if the ball should make it that deep as they hang out in their own end zone. And here's the kick from Crawford. This one a deep line drive. And it's going to be Nance. Nance with a hole up the middle, dives, and rolls shy of the 20.
Nice tackle there by LJ McConnell. This is a monstrous defensive possession here for the Fighters. They have to find a way to put the brakes on this Tulsa offense. And Tulsa's really used some misdirection tonight.
Fighters were able to garner a turnover on downs in the third quarter on the first possession for the Tulsa Oilers, which really set the tone for the second half because the Oilers deferred, so they were with the lead starting things off in the second half. Couldn't get anything done. However, the Fighter defense faltering on the last offensive drive for Tulsa as they were able to punch it in.
They're using flat motion here.
Ball gets handed off. And that ball goes to DeBose. But a flag on the play. It's one of the players down there. I think that's Smith. Yeah, quarterback Smith wearing the yellow shoes. No, there is actually a yellow flag down there.
There is no foul in the play. The block was deemed to be legal. Taken down.
Oh, okay.
But there should not have been a flag down there. So the flag is picked up. There was no call on the play. And
Yeah, maybe
the indoor war will carry on.
Maybe they thought there was an illegal kind of crack block there from a stationary wide receiver, but Austin and them say, nope, that's within the rules. And Frisco, second and eight here, needs another big stop.
I love the hustle of which the Oilers get to that line.
Uh-oh.
Plenty of room and space for Daniel Smith as he hops at the 20. And he almost looked as if he couldn't believe there was that big of a lane open for him.
Yeah, good job by Smith realizing what he's got in that situation and taking advantage of it. Frisco's in man-to-man coverage, and if you don't hold your gaps in your rush in man-to-man, you can get gashed. And luckily for the Fighters, that wasn't TJ running in the open field. That might have been a bigger gain.
Smith with the toss. You mentioned being lucky that there wasn't TJ on the ground. So the former Barnstormer, Smith, grabbing 150 yards on the ground on just 28 attempts and one rushing score last season. A little bit different than TJ Edwards' stats when running the football.
I believe Smith also played in the NAL, the National Arena League, last year as well. And you can tell that game's played with more anticipation and touch in the throwing game. And I see it for sure tonight. He's done a wonderful job.
It was with the West Texas Warbirds, excuse me, of the NAL. 47 touchdowns with the West Texas Warbirds. A flag down as that one goes deep into the stands.
It's called by the umpire, so we may have an illegal rush here. I'm not sure. I didn't see it. I was watching the defensive backfield. But anytime the umpire calls, it's either a hold or an illegal blitz.
Illegal defense. Number 24, Frisco, is not stationary at the snap.
Nope.
5-yard penalty.
Mack moving at the snap.
Still down.
Goes against Royce C., turning linebacker for the Frisco Fighters.
Yeah, just got a little antsy there.
Well, the crowd's going to chant it. We'll see if the Frisco Fighters can do it. Defense needed now more than ever here at the 9:30 mark in the final frame. Tulsa looking for some redemption after an 0-2 record against Frisco last season as that ball almost intercepted. Not sure what Smith saw.
It sure looks like Charles Williams got held on that play. I'm not sure exactly, but
Ethan Castleberry almost with the ability to intercept that football.
I was wrong.
Solomon Wise with the personal foul, roughing the passer. A massive penalty to take at this point in the ball game.
Yeah, that was not good timing for that.
Crowd here very upset at the call. As coming off the field, Jonathan Nance looks like an limping a little bit. So Tulsa going to take their second timeout. I think, Dan, and you can disagree with me here, but this seems to be a pretty strategic one of, hey, if we can punch one in, there may be a good chance we can hold on and win this ball game. So let's take our time, but we will find out if that is the case momentarily. 25-11, Oilers lead. 15, Dan Radabaugh, high snap for Smith, out of the timeout, caught at the five. And it's DeBose.
Yeah, good catch there by Smith at quarterback, kind of a little snaps off a little bit, makes a quick catch, throws a quick ball out to the running back in the flat, and they've been nothing but efficient tonight.
Certainly have. Smith doing a wonderful job leading this franchise in their second season, joining them after spending some time with Iowa last year, 12 games to be exact. Clock continuing to roll. Frisco
under center. They've been using flat motion under center all night.
Running out of time. Toss outside. Stop.
Good
Stutter
job.
Stutter step. And no gain on the play. And Frisco saw that coming a mile away. And
remember, they scored on that exact play earlier where you run the jet sweep and then you pitch back into the boundary. And Frisco was all over it. And look who's under the pile there causing havoc. Number 11, our leader, Charles Williams.
One of the big names returning this season for the Frisco Fighters alongside TJ Edwards.
Yeah, I want to say Charles is a three straight first team all league defender. He's notorious for causing problems in the backfield, and he's also one of the best special teams players in the league.
So now third down, desperately needing a stop of the Fighters. Smith, extra long look. This ball incomplete.
Good defense. Right in his hip pocket there. It would have had to have been a dime, and I still think he might have stopped him before he got in the end zone, but big time play. They're going to send the kicker out.
It looks like they're going to go for it. On fourth down inside the five at the four.
I like it. Good call by Coach Jones there. Be aggressive.
Marvin Jones in his second season as head coach, trying to build off of a 2-13 year last year, off to a wonderful start to this campaign, win or loss. This Tulsa Oilers team proving a lot of people wrong of what they thought this team would be.
Yeah, Frisco's got to be gap sound here. Don't just go flying upfield and open a rush lane. Oh, another timeout.
Kind of like what I was saying earlier is that right now feels like the time to burn them because you're not going to want to stop the clock later. You want to keep it rolling and give Frisco the opportunity to run out of time. So using this timeout saying, hey, let's really make sure we know what we want to do because an extra touchdown here could put this one away for us.
Yeah, for sure. And, you know, they're not a team that's played with the lead a ton either. So they're getting used to this as well. So in my past, you know, growing through this league and my experience, never call a timeout until it's the last minute just because you want to have them in that last minute. But the indoor football league is a little different than the game I played. I played in the arena football league. There's a little more onside kicks and stuff like that. But Tulsa's doing everything they can to try to put it away right here on this drive.
I see no movement from the bench about sending Newfield out.
Nope.
They will continue with the rules of engagement, those being we're going to go for this ball here on fourth down and four.
Yeah, for a team that only had two wins last year, they sure are playing with a lot of confidence tonight in the opener.
Confidence and gutsy, things you have to be here in the IFL. Not wanting to play it safe with a field goal. Smith, perfect
start.
Snap.
Yeah.
It's tackled in the backfield. The Fighters with the biggest stop of the evening. Charles Williams, Royce C. all up in on it. Caleb Thomas also coming out of the pile. And this place is on its feet. That is exactly what the Frisco Fighters needed.
There's some electricity, baby. I like it. Charles Williams, who else would you expect to make a big play when we needed it? Good call by the defense. They really tightened up there in the secondary on that drive, too. No open wide receivers that whole time. Good job. You see them in there screaming at each other, trying to go down and get some motivation. We need six.
Now, if that doesn't fire up your offense to go and pay your defense back with some points, I don't know what will. 8-point lead for the Tulsa Oilers. That ball handed off to Smith on the right side.
I like it. They're in a zone coverage. That's a great time to run the football. They don't have that extra linebacker up in the alley in the box. Good.
Frisco can go down, score the touchdown, and go for two.
We don't need to be in a rush here either.
But also don't need to be in a rush. Just saying if this were their last drive, there is the ability to tie this game. It's a one-score game.
Mm-hmm. And then
go for the deuce.
The deuce.
Deuce it up. Edwards, snap. This one's perfect. At his chest. Tucks keeps it. Edwards with the juke. Falling down at the 25. Grabbing the first down and plenty more.
Now, I was watching the wide receivers on that play, and Cole Blackman came downhill, was running full speed, making it look like a pass play, and absolutely demolished the defensive back with a wonderful block. But there goes our magic man, T.J. Edwards, finding a groove. Big play right there. Looks like they're starting to get a little momentum. Need to capitalize.
Talked about Tulsa playing with confidence, some gutsy play calling. They probably would love to have had that field goal right about now, putting this into a two-score game. Edwards rolls, plenty of time and space, and goes to the wall, and again for the second time this evening, falls over the wall on a late flag from Austin Wright. Imagine this is going to be a late hit.
Yeah, they're going to protect the quarterback, but
after
as mobile and
over,
as athletic as TJ
on
is.
On sportsmanlike conduct, Tulsa number 15 pushing the player over the wall. Half the distance to the goal, automatic, first down.
As athletic as TJ is, as much as he runs the ball, every time he goes towards the wall, I always feel like he doesn't go over with enough conviction, giving himself up out of bounds. If you look here, look, kind of lets up a little bit. I don't recommend doing that around defenders.
Keandre Hall, you see his nameplate there, is the one caught red-handed with the roughing, or unnecessary roughness, excuse me. Pushing Edwards over the wall. Puts Frisco in an excellent spot here with 5:10 remaining in the ball game. Another handoff to Smith. He's seen plenty of action tonight, and this is going to be a face mask on Lyles.
I'm going to go with holding on Noah. But it could be holding on the defense, too.
First
foul, face mask. Number seven.
That might be the only time I ever beat you in a call-off,
hey,
man.
Hey, that's why we're teammates, right? We work well together. Good job seeing that.
Can we clip this and have it in my personal little diary? Well, we don't need to point that out.
Well, they
got the face mask.
Yeah, there was definitely a few things being held on that play. A face mask, a uniform.
Breaths.
Not a yellow flag, though. It definitely was unleashed.
Again, hard to see the yellow flag sometimes with the Tulsa Oilers and their mustard yellow helmets.
And their yellow gloves or
yellow shoes.
Yeah, it's tough.
Fortunately, no yellow towels. That would really make it interesting. Edwards, though, in a prime position.
Oh!
As he loses the football and is fumbled and picked up by Tulsa. No way! You could not have dialed up a worse string of luck for the Frisco Fighters as Morris is handed a gift on the five. And this place has fallen dead silent. And there is an injured Tulsa Oiler down on the field. When we find out who it is, we'll let you know.
It's Noah Lyles. He was involved on the tackle with TJ, and it almost looks like his elbow jammed into the ground, which can really kind of shoot your shoulder up into the socket and cause some issues.
Coach Coles holding on to the red challenge flag was talking to Austin Wright, and he's going to toss it at the 25.
They're challenging that there is a legal defense on the previous play.
Challenging for
the
linebacker defense
was not set at the back of the box.
And Austin Wright and his crew will go take a look at the broadcast on their screen and see what's going on as Noah Lyles is able to walk off the field under his own strength. But my goodness, there could not have been a worse time for a second turnover of the ball game as Edwards just completely loses control of it. It rolls about 10 yards and right,
yeah.
And I mean right, into the comforting arms of Morris.
He took off with it like he knew what he was doing, didn't he? Here we go. Let's check a replay.
Certainly be a good time for one.
See, in my mind, that's a give. You should give that to the back.
And shout out to Lyles, the injured player on the play there, because he punched that ball on a reach.
Yeah, but they're challenging illegal defense. I didn't see it there. They said the linebackers weren't set at the back of the box. Apologize, I wasn't watching for it. I was watching the flow of the play.
Well, I think, too, just seeing about how that fumble came to be was just as important. although this will be the decision.
Yeah.
Number five.
Yeah, he's not set.
Lined
he's moving
up inside the box. Be half the distance to the goal.
Talk about.
I'll be at the 2.5 yard line.
The eyes of head coach Coles and his team.
Frisco.
Seeing that.
Is not charged
the call.
For a timeout.
Yeah, but oh, TJ's got to give that ball to the back there. If the D end is able to tackle you as the quarterback, it's a give. And I expect TJ to get sharper as the season goes on. But he hasn't quite been the TJ that we saw all of last season. But if he can find that magic here for the next 4 minutes and 30 seconds, I think the Fighters may like the outcome.
So what was a flipped field in favor of the Oilers gets called back on the illegal defense challenge from head coach Coles and the Frisco Fighters. Even better opportunity to punch one in and bring this game within a couple of points. This one's getting exciting. Edwards tucks, keeps, reaches, end zone! Touchdown, Fighters! T.J. Edwards with the extra reach, barely breaking the plane, but enough to grab six.
Yep, and Dre's going to go ahead and go for two here. I like it. Good call. I'd call the same play.
You're down two. Makes sense to go for two.
Yep. Good job by TJ there. Just quarterback lead. He's able to sneak it in, but, okay, you look at the situation. We got to have the two here. Coach Coles decides to put it on the left college. We'll probably see an empty set or trips to the field here. He may even do some misdirection with a flat motion coming towards the field and then maybe TJ a backside zone, but Frisco's got to call their best play right here. They have to have this.
This place will lose its mind if they're able to convert. Opportunity for the Fighters to tie it. They're in a rush to get this ball off. Edwards going to take a timeout. As some confusion down on the field. And Coach Cole's going to call the squad in.
Timeout. Frisco, their second charge timeout of the half. It'll be 30 seconds in length. Game clock operator, please put 3-1-5 on the game clock.
No one's going
3-1-5.
They're not taking any timeouts into this last minute.
Use them if you got them. I think that's the term.
Yeah, something like that.
But talk about a crazy last 30 seconds, Dan. We thought the fumble was going to end this thing for the Fighters.
And then he works his magic, just like we said, didn't he?
Coles challenges, gets it, wins the challenge, keeps the timeout. Edwards punches it in. And now the Fighters going for two.
Okay, here you go. Empty set, empty trips right, trade.
Home and season opener could be on the line right here for the Fighters.
Yeah, Tulsa in press man coverage, making you beat them.
Here we go. Lobber, end zone, caught!
Great call, Dre.
And just like that, as easy as can be, Lionel McConnell putting his mark on this ball game.
Yeah, Frisco runs a quick little slip there to the back of the end zone. They know they're in press coverage. Not great leverage by the Tulsa DB. Lets him cross his face and then just kind of lets him go. That's a no-no. Number one rule as a DB is no one crosses your face inside, and then you never backpedal in the end zone, and you put both of those together. It's a recipe to get beat. Great execution. Good job, TJ. We got a ball game, baby.
And we brought up the deuce, Dan.
I'd love it if Bryce dropped a deuce on us right here.
Had a handful of them last year. I want to say it was two or three. I don't have it in front of me right now, but an opportunity here where they could easily take the lead in this ball game should Bryce Crawford go for it. And it is his home field, which I feel like if you're a kicker, you know your home field best.
Well, didn't he have a game at home last year where he had two in one game?
He did.
Yeah. Hey, he's the reigning kicker of the year or first team all IFL kicker last year? Had a kick to beat Tulsa in a game last year. No better time than now, Bryce. Dial up one.
Bryce the Leg, his nickname. I don't know if that's true or not. It doesn't even rhyme. But the spotlight certainly on the kicker. You think being an NFL kicker is high pressure. Talk about being an IFL kicker.
You know me, what I'm asking for right here. Onside kick it.
I think you've said that just about every opportunity.
They're leaving
so far
it open.
This game. Crawford looking for short. The deuce. That one is too high here at Comerica Center. Off the rafters, the light is swinging There used to be a Jumbotron of speakers right there at the 25. They pulled those away. Still not enough height. So the ball will go to the 20.
And Tulsa.
The Tulsa Oilers. And, I mean, shoot, you look at the clock, 3 minutes. That's a lifetime in the IFL. If there is an opportunity for overtime, though, there's a look at the rules. A little bit like a modified college version.
Yeah, both teams will get the ball starting on the other team's 20.
You mean a coin flip doesn't determine who the winner is?
No. And something tells me that there's a chance there could be one or two more touchdowns in this ball game. So.
Oh, I would not be surprised in the least bit with 3 minutes to go. And, again, it's a one-minute warning, not a two-minute warning, as this ball gets tossed.
Good defense. They try to run a toss fold there where you crack down with the receiver and you try to pull a guard out front, and Frisco's all over it.
Tell you what, who is – understood the assignment in the second half. That's the Frisco Fighter defense. They have completely
great
dominant, only given up one score so far here and two massive stops, one on that opening drive and then one on the previous drive for the Oilers to give Frisco a chance to tie the ball game.
Great pursuit there by Royce C. Middle linebacker making a big play for you when you need it.
Daniel Smith trying to make some fireworks happen. Ball's tossed, caught at the 25. Just give you a guess on who caught that. As it's Montrose.
Daniel Smith with another quick decision, accurate pass, gets him back into a manageable third down. He's playing the quarterback position, how you draw it up. And he's not a particularly super mobile guy like TJ either, but he's still finding ways to be effective with his arms tonight. I'm really impressed.
Red River Rumble 2024 to open up the IFL season. Smith going to take this one himself. Gets
There's
across the 20 and pushed out just shy, or actually right on the 15.
Now, he's not as mobile as TJ, but that's not to say he's not mobile. That was a nice 10-yard pickup. It's all about being decisive. Sticks his foot in the ground, gets north-south. He's done a good job. If he can continue to grow, Tulsa's going to be a tough team to deal with each week. Here we go, one-minute warning.
Looks like that's where they will take the play clock down to. Get a free timeout, if you will. Very nice steel boot trophy on the line here for this Red River Rumble. 25 apiece, down to the one-minute warning.
Yeah, Fighters have done a great job clawing back into this ball game, but we've seen lots of action inside the last minutes in plenty of Frisco Fighter games, so I expect Tulsa to continue to call good plays at the right time, and Frisco just needs to keep making plays on defense.
We're going to go ahead and leave it here for now because this is getting down to the wire, 25 apiece. Ryan Medellin, Dan Rodabaugh here in Frisco, Texas again. 0-2 last year, the Tulsa Oilers against the Frisco Fighters. They had had the edge the entire ball game, and Frisco refueling midair and clawing their way back into this one. The defense
coming alive here in the second half, for sure.
The mitigating factor that has really allowed Frisco to have this opportunity to be in this situation.
Yeah, and hey, the crowd's getting into it too. It's coming to life here, and no better time than now. See if we can't force a turnover or get them in a situation where they are debating between kicking and going for it. So be gap sound in the run game. Watch the misdirections. Have tight coverage. Looks like
Neufeld does not have a field goal this evening. Should they have to settle for that to try and grab some points before the clock runs out. 1 minute left.
Run.
Game tied at 25 apiece. And there's that Fighter defensive line.
Castleberry right in it again.
Jumping all over to Bose.
That reminds me how Cordell Jackson used to get involved in the run game last year. He was shot out of a cannon. You know, he wasn't a big guy, but, man, he played like a missile. And Castleberry sure has found his way to be impactful in the run game from the defensive backfield.
According to what I'm seeing, Frisco does not have a timeout left. Tulsa has one.
Yeah, everyone's been using them tonight. They've been popular.
Clock down to 25, still tied. Oilers with the ball. Handoff up the middle. Space rolling to the 10.
They're going to kick this. They're going to run this down to 3 seconds and kick it.
Clock is still rolling.
What are they doing?
They haven't done anything. Got to call the timeout. Did
no,
they get it
no.
off in time? There's
what
a
are they doing? And he kneeled it anyways. That right? Or did he? I couldn't tell what he did.
There was mass confusion on the field from the Oilers. Let's see what Austin Wright has to say.
Time expired on the play.
Wow.
That is
we're
in
going
the regulation.
Overtime. What?
We will take
were they
a 2 minute break and then begin overtime procedures.
As well as Tulsa has coached tonight, they totally
you had a timeout
goofed that up.
In the bag. And they don't what? Utilize it.
I don't even know what just happened.
And now we're going to overtime. There's still confusion. The players on the field putting their hands up saying, what the heck just happened? Well, anyways, Dan, we're going to overtime.
Yeah, you get some free football, baby.
And again, if you didn't look at see the rules earlier, there they are right now. Each overtime consisting of both teams getting a possession, starting on their own opponent's 20. Still tied. We'll go to a second one. After the third attempt. You got to attempt the two-point conversion. So very college-esque in the way that they handle overtime. So now the marching orders being given to the crew. I think we may have time for a short break. We'll take it. 25 apiece, headed to overtime next.
Ain't got no choice but to lace up. Every day is game day. Off my third contract, you still on that same play. Lying harder, but I got the eye of an eagle. I put the city on my back. Look, I'm gonna ride for my people. And once I take the stage, I'ma start like Evel Knievel. I built to conquer heights. My mind's a Danny DeVito. And once I get my first ring, I'm manifesting the sequel. Yo, this the IFL. Swear to man, become heroes of in the end. Are you ready for that?
The rules are overtime are similar to the NCAA game. However, each team will get one possession from the 20-yard line. If you fail to score or convert a first down from that series, it'll be a turnover on downs. The other team will get their opportunity. If the defense scores other than on a try, the game is over. We will continue that procedure until we declare a winner, switching ends of the field at that time. Both teams get one timeout per series. At the third overtime, if you score a touchdown, you must go for two.
So it appears Austin Wright's mic has gone out. Ryan Medine, Dan Rodabaugh here. Frisco won the toss. I believe I saw T.J.
Frisco
Edwards say
won
the
top and elected to go on defense first.
Oh,
it'll
okay.
be first and 10
wrong.
From the 20-yard line, Tulsa.
50% chance. But Austin Wright finally gets his mic working, and Frisco deferred, so they will play defense first. I don't know if you caught that note in there that if the defense should score on the try, then they are able to win the game if they take it back.
Yeah. Now, I know the – it said the – you get it on the opponent's 20, right?
Correct.
So you got 20 yards to go. All right. Come on, Frisco. Still got to play gap sound, right? We're just playing normal football here. Any plays in play. The run game, all those jet sweeps, any of that misdirection. So you still got to play sound responsibility football.
For those wondering how he got here, Tulsa, they had a timeout, at least all signs showing that they did, unless there's something up here we didn't know. Didn't use it, and the clock ran out when they were inside the five. Smith runs it, slides across the 15. So a very weird ending. One of the strangest ones that I've seen to send this game to overtime when if you send out your kicker, and look, we have seen a couple times now where Newfield wasn't on the field for a field goal attempt when they probably could have, and maybe there's something going on there. We're not sure. It's just speculation. But definitely interesting they did not use a timeout and try and get a field goal.
Yeah, that mean who knows what happened there, but that was definitely one of the stranger endings of a game I've seen. But
have to get a debrief from Austin Wright. This pass from Smith, end zone sliding. No good. Pass is incomplete. The coverage.
Castleberry all over him
from
again.
From Frisco was Castleberry. And Jonathan Nance not able to add to his touchdown total this evening.
Good timing by Smith again. He's been on time all night. Hasn't been completely accurate every single throw, but he has not missed by much very often.
Talk about where defense matters most. The Frisco Fighter defense has been stellar here in the second half, and overtime is just about as big of a time as you'd need them than any, because if you get a stop on these next couple of downs, you set your team up for an opportunity to take this one away.
Yeah, big play here. If they can hold them to.
Empty back for Smith. Another toss into the end zone. Intercepted! There is a flag.
I mean, it could be offensive pass interference. It almost looked like a pick route, but it's going to be illegal contact. Oh, no, it is. It's offensive pass interference.
Waiting for Austin Wright's call. Lionel McConnell
was the
one.
Offense.
That grabbed the interception, and it will stand as it was offensive pass interference.
We're going to get in the second part of the series. First and 10.
And now the Fighters with an opportunity to put this one away.
Any score wins here, right? Yep.
As it is the second team, yes.
Wow, great job, defense. Run a little zone coverage there, kind of mix up the look, has the quarterback fooled a little bit, and they try to run a rub route off of each other, and good call by the referee, understanding the situation and the illegal route there.
Another look at it, McConnell jumps all over that one. He was almost waiting, knowing the opportunity was coming.
Yeah.
And with the offensive pass interference, it will stand.
And LJ McConnell, wide receiver last year, comes into training camp this year. They're looking for bodies to maybe play in the defensive backfield. Andre says, we're going to give you a shot back there, and he makes a wonderful play. Now look at him, too. He's out here on offense.
If that's the stamp the Fighters' defense can put on this game, it is certainly well-deserved. T.J. Edwards now needs to make the most of it. As Smith, completely shifting gears, moving sides, gets inside the 15.
Great call there. Great job by Jimmy. Kind of getting out of some junk in the backfield. TJ even throws a block on Jones, the middle linebacker. Jimmy makes another guy miss, sneaks up the wall. Second and 5. Don't press here. There's no time, right? Just run your best plays, execute to a high level, take what they give you.
It has not been the Fighters' best game that we've seen them play, but boy, have they fought for this one with an opportunity to win it. TJ Edwards looking for another score on the ground inside the 10. And a new set of downs for the quarterback.
Yeah, good job. Got to think ball security here, right? Turnover kills us. So keep it going. Two hands on the ball when there's people around you. Make a good decision if it's a passing play. And we got to secure that snap. Center quarterback exchange. It's been good the last few drives.
Tulsa 0-2 against the Fighters last season. Had an opportunity to win this ball game, was out to a lead at the half and let the clock run out with a timeout in hand. just inside the Fighter 5 earlier to start it to overtime. This ball handed off to Smith, a nice spin move, but he is absolutely hammered down at the 7.
That was a big collision there. I hope that guy's okay. He's almost face mask to face mask.
And now limping off is
Keandre Hall,
the linebacker.
Yeah, it looks like he might have got his bell rung there. Shake some of those cobwebs out. Hope he's okay.
So everybody here in Frisco on their feet, and a clap for Keandre Hall as he's able to, again, walk off under his own strength. Ryan Medellin, Dan Radabaugh here bringing you all the action here from Comerica Center in Frisco, Texas for their home and season opener for the Frisco Fighters and season opener for the Tulsa Oilers in their second year as an organization after going 2-13 last season, trying to turn the tide. And pretty much the entire ball game, people were scratching their heads about how Frisco could be losing. Wasn't their night. Tulsa taking advantage, but now the Fighters in the pilot seat. Smith puts his head down, driving, stopped shy, down to the 2.
So we got third down, right?
And now will be third down, 2 to go.
You'd prefer not to have to kick a field goal to try to win the game, but I don't see what's wrong with running that exact same play or the trusty TJ quarterback lead.
Maybe bring in the heavy package like we saw earlier. It appears as if that is exactly what's happening. Damian Love, Mitchell, and Noah Johnson.
Yes, got some big boys up front. Got to drive them off the ball here.
It's Edwards and Smith. Edwards going to take it himself. Outside into the end zone. TJ Edwards securing the victory for the Frisco Fighters, escaping the home opener by the hairs on their chinny chin chins in what has been one of the more wild openers I have seen in my short IFL career. But a sigh of relief sweeps across the Comerica Center. Frisco Fighters win it in overtime, 31-25.
What an ending. That was a wild ending to that one. I mean, the clock management there at the end of the game by Tulsa just makes you wonder what was going on.
Wow. Talk about.
And you can see it on the faces of those Tulsa players. They knew they had that ball game. They look heartbroken.
I mean, I'm not even sure how to pontificate the game that just happened in front of us, because that was absolutely everybody on the edge of their seat.
Yeah,
the entire evening.
And credit Coach Coles and the Fighters for hanging in that ball game, finding a way to keep fighting and never let it get more than 2 possessions away. Defense stepped up in the second half, and offense is able to find points when they needed them. Great ending. Hey, not pretty, but at the end of the season, it doesn't tell you if it was a pretty win or not. It just says win or loss.
Well, that was an excellent game, and we certainly enjoyed it here for this home opener. Frisco Fighters will then now host Duke City next Friday night here at Comerica Center. It is Dallas Stars night. That would be a fun one, but certainly a fun one here in Frisco tonight, as it's a 31-25 win for the Frisco Fighters in overtime. For myself, Ryan Medellin, for Dan Radabaugh, my partner, for our producer, Blaine Tatum, and for everybody back at the truck that made this one possible, we thank you so much for joining us. Tune in next week as the Fighters host Duke City. Good evening, everybody.